Hello everyone, I'm Kiri Patel from Electrical Department, LDIP Engineering College, Gandhinagar. In today's lecture, we will discuss about representation of short transmission line. Before starting my topic, I want to give you a brief introduction about what is a transmission line. A transmission line is a conductive line which is used for transmission of electrical power from one place to another place is known as transmission line. What is the classification of transmission line? You already studied in power system 1. In our system, there are two types of transmission line, overhead and underground. In an underground, generally we can use as a cable. In an overhead transmission line, further can be classified with the three types, short, medium, and long transmission line. First, see what is a short, medium, and long transmission line. In brief, depending on the length and voltage, we can classify this three transmission line. Short transmission line, line having length less than 80 km and operating voltage less than 20 kV are generally known as short transmission line. Due to small distance and low voltage, capacitance effect is negligible. That means in short transmission line, only we consider resistance and inductive effect. What is the medium transmission line? The transmission line having length between 80 to 240 km and line voltage having 20 kV to 100 kV are considered as a medium transmission line. Due to appreciable length and voltage of line, charging current is appreciable and therefore capacitance effect needed to be considered. Although the capacitance is distributed uniformly over the entire length of line, yet it is assumed to be concentrated at some or more point. For calculation of a medium transmission line, we can use three methods, any condenser method, nominal T method, and nominal pi method. What is a long transmission line? Transmission line having length above 240 km and line voltage above 100 kV are generally considered as a long transmission line. In this line, line constants are considered uniformly distributed, not lumped over entire length of a line, and their solution we can use rigorous method. What is the performance of transmission line? The design and operation of transmission line is greatly influenced by voltage drop, line losses, and efficiency of transmission system. All these factors related to transmission system are depend on line parameters like resistance, inductance, and capacitance. Resistance is the opposition to flow of current by line conductor because resistivity of conductor's material is called as resistance of a line. Inductance, when alternating current flows through a conductor, a charging flux is set up which links the conductor itself. Due to this flux leakage, the conductor has an inductance. What is the capacitance? As we know, that there are two conductors separated by an insulating material constitute a capacitance. A transmission line are separated by air. Capacitance also exists between two lines. Important term like voltage regulation and transmission efficiency. What is the voltage regulation? The voltage regulation of transmission line is defined as the ratio between difference between sending end and receiving end voltage to receiving end voltage of transmission line is known as voltage regulation. That means percentage voltage regulation is equal to Vs minus Vr upon Vr into 100. What is the transmission efficiency? The power obtained at the receiving end of a transmission line is generally less than the sending end power. Due to losses in the line resistance, the ratio of receiving end power to the sending end power of a transmission line is known as transmission efficiency. That means percentage transmission efficiency is equal to receiving end power upon sending end power into 100. What is a short transmission line? A transmission line is defined as a transmission. A short transmission line is defined as a transmission line which has effective length less than 80 km and voltage less than 20 kV. For short transmission line, the shunt capacitance of this type of line is neglected. Only resistance and inductor effect we can calculate. See, R and XL in a circuit is connected with a load. The input side voltage is a sending end voltage VS. Load side voltage is a receiving end voltage VR. I is a current. Here I is a load current. R is a loop resistance. XL is a loop reactance. VR is a receiving end voltage. Cos phi is a receiving end power factor. VS is a sending end voltage. Cos phi is a sending end power factor. Here we take I is a reference. VS is a total supply voltage. VR is the receiving end voltage. IR and IXL is a drop. Angle between I and VR is a phi R. Angle between I and phi S is a VS is a phi S. With a phasor diagram, you can calculate OC square is equal to OD square plus DC square. OD is equal to OD is equal to OE plus ED. That means VS square is equal to VR cos phi plus IR whole square plus VR sin phi plus IXL whole square. We get equation VS is equal to under root of VR cos phi plus IR square plus VS sin phi plus IXL square. To find the percentage voltage regulation, equation here, Vs minus Vr upon Vr into 100. Sending end power factor cos phi is equal to OD by OC. See, OD by OC. That means cos phi is equal to Vr cos phi plus Ir upon Vs. Power delivered, Vr Ir cos phi. Power line losses is the I square R losses. Power sent out, VR IR cos phi plus losses. That means VR IR cos phi plus I square R. Percentage transmission efficiency is equal to power delivered by power sent out. Equation VR IR cos phi upon VR IR cos phi plus I square R into 100. What is the advantage of overhead transmission line? It's cheaper to install, maintenance is easy, it's a good cooling condition, quicker to fix, quicker to find the fault. There are, they have a large transmission capacity. What is the disadvantage of overhead transmission line? It's difficult to erect it in an area where the network is complex and concentrated. Not very safe to be erected in a densely population area of city, affected by environmental conditions such as the temperature, wind, rain, like that, and it's influenced by thunder and lightning effect. Okay, thank you.